to me, it's this wonderful sort of never-ending curiosity journey where I get to go taste foods and come back and sort of reinterpret it in the way that it makes sense in my home kitchen. But I'm always trying to stay true to the original and learn from, you know, these traditions that are centuries or millennia old. Comfort foods. There's fresh, like yesterday I got to have a big Iranian kebab feast with my family, so that was really comforting. Like butter and rice and like the grilled tomato that you smush into it, that is a really old flavor in my like body that I love. But I think rice is probably my ultimate comfort food in any form. So I eat a lot of congee. I have a rice cooker. I finally got an appliance. I got an appliance, guys. And I'm like, rice cooker? It's amazing. It just keeps the rice warm. You get to eat it whenever you want. So I think rice is probably my most like fundamental. I grew up eating it every day. So Mexican food. I grew up in Southern California. Like it's the taste of my childhood is Mexican food. I'll always choose it. And, you know, a lot of people don't really realize that condiments, you know, they're often a source of acid and salt and fat. And so these are the things that can take like a simple bowl of rice with a fried egg to so many different countries. You know, you can put kimchi on there, you can put sriracha on there, you can put any matter of like hot sauces or pickles, and suddenly have this simple thing be, you know, taking your journey on a journey around the world. So I often, like, I live by myself, so often I do this thing, which maybe I need to stop doing, but like I'll cook a whole pot of beans and then I'll eat it for like 7 days. But every day I'll maybe add a different spice or a different herb or make some sort of slightly different thing. And I'm always taking advantage of the condiments though. The condiment situation, I think, is exemplary in my fridge. Yeah.